Imagine a world where your innermost thoughts are no longer private. Artificial intelligence is now knocking on the door of your mind. Scientists are using AI to decode brain activity. They can translate what you're seeing or even what you're thinking into words and images. This is a monumental leap. Think about individuals who cannot speak or move. For them, this could be a key, unlocking communication with the world. But with great power, as we know, comes great responsibility. Are our thoughts truly our own if they can be read? We stand at a fascinating and perhaps slightly unsettling crossroads. AI acts as our guide, our interpreter in this new exploration. It sifts through the noisy chatter of neurons. The journey is just beginning and the map is still being drawn, so buckle up. We're about to dive deep into the science of AI-powered thought reading. Let's start with one of the key tools, fMRI. That stands for Functional Magnetic Resonance Imaging. It's a big machine, like a giant donut you slide into. But instead of looking for a snack, it's looking at your brain activity. How does it do this? It tracks blood flow. When a part of your brain works harder, it needs more oxygen. More oxygen means more blood rushes to that area. fMRI detects these changes in blood oxygenation. It's like seeing which parts of a city light up at night. The fMRI machine uses powerful magnets and radio waves. These magnets are thousands of times stronger than a fridge magnet. They align the protons in your body's water molecules. Then, a radio wave pulse knocks these protons out of alignment. As they realign, they release signals that the fMRI detects. Oxygen-rich blood and oxygen-poor blood have different magnetic properties. This difference is what fMRI picks up, called the bold signal. So, fMRI doesn't read thoughts directly, not like a mind-reading psychic. Instead, it creates detailed 3D maps of brain activity. These maps show which brain regions are active during specific tasks. Now let's talk about another amazing tool, EEG. EEG stands for electroencephalography. It's a way to listen to the brain's electrical symphony. Your brain cells, neurons, communicate using tiny electrical impulses. Billions of them firing together create electrical fields. These fields can be detected even on the surface of your scalp. EEG uses small electrodes like tiny microphones placed on your head. They pick up these faint electrical signals. Unlike fMRI, EEG doesn't require a giant, expensive machine. It's relatively portable and much cheaper. You might see someone wearing an EEG cap, looking a bit like a high-tech swimmer. Those electrodes are capturing the brain's rhythms or waves. You've probably heard of brain waves, alpha, beta, delta, theta, gamma. These different wave patterns are associated with different states, like deep sleep, relaxation, focused attention, or active thinking. EEG is excellent at tracking these states in real time. The big advantage of EEG is its superb temporal resolution. It can detect changes in brain activity almost instantly. So, we have these amazing machines, fMRI and EEG. They collect vast amounts of data about brain activity. But this data is just a flood of numbers and signals. How do we make sense of it? How do we find the thoughts? Enter artificial intelligence, our cosmic translator. AI algorithms, particularly machine learning, are the key. They are trained to find patterns in this complex brain data. Patterns that correspond to specific thoughts, images, or intentions. Think of it like teaching a child to recognize objects. You show the child many pictures of a cat, saying cat each time. Eventually, the child learns to identify a cat on its own. AI learns in a similar way, but on a much grander scale. Researchers show the AI many examples of brain activity. For instance, they might have a person look at pictures of faces while in an fMRI scanner. The AI is fed the brain scan data paired with the images of faces. It learns to associate specific patterns of brain activity with seeing a face. This training process can be incredibly intensive. It requires a lot of data and a lot of computational power. The AI models, often deep learning networks, have many layers. Each layer learns to recognize increasingly complex features. Painting pictures from Thought's AI's visual reconstructions. One of the most mind-blowing applications is reconstructing images from brain activity. Imagine seeing a picture in your mind's eye, and then having an AI sketch out what you're visualizing. This is becoming a reality, thanks to fMRI and sophisticated AI. Researchers will show a person a series of images, say, a bird, a house, a car. While the person looks at these images, their brain activity is recorded using fMRI. This data, paired with the original images, is fed into an AI model. The AI learns to map specific brain activation patterns to visual features. Once trained, the AI can try to reconstruct a new image. An image the person is seeing, but that the AI hasn't been trained on directly. The AI analyzes the new pattern of brain activity. It then generates an image that it predicts would cause that brain pattern. The results are not yet perfect, photorealistic copies. They are often blurry, impressionistic, like a dream. But they can be remarkably recognizable. If you were looking at a face, the AI might generate a face-like image. It's like the AI is trying to see through your eyes. This technology relies heavily on understanding how the visual cortex works. Unlocking voices, a new dawn for communication. Perhaps the most immediate and profound impact of this technology is for communication. Think about people with locked-in syndrome. They are fully conscious and aware, but completely paralyzed, unable to speak, unable to move, trapped inside their own bodies. For them, any means of communication is a lifeline. AI-powered brain-computer interfaces, or BCIs, offer incredible hope. These systems can decode attempted speech or imagine movements from brain signals, turning thoughts directly into words on a screen or commands for a device. Researchers are making amazing progress in this area. Using EEG or electrocorticography, known as ECOG, which involves electrodes placed directly on the brain's surface. ECOG is more invasive but provides clearer signals. Participants imagine speaking words or moving a cursor. The AI learns the brain patterns associated with these intentions. Some systems can now decode imagined speech at impressive speeds, allowing users to type messages using only their thoughts. It's like giving them a mental keyboard. This isn't just about typing messages, it's about restoring autonomy and connection. Imagine being able to control a wheelchair with your thoughts, or simply tell a loved one, "I love you," after years of silence. The emotional impact is immeasurable. Beyond words expanding human potential, while communication for nonverbal individuals is a primary focus, the potential extends further. Think about mental health diagnostics. Could AI analyze brain patterns from fMRI or EEG to help identify conditions like depression or anxiety earlier? AI could pick up on subtle changes that a human observer might miss. This could lead to more personalized and timely interventions, not replacing doctors, but providing them with powerful new tools. Understanding the brain's activity could revolutionize how we approach mental well-being. Consider the realm of education and learning. Imagine AI systems that could adapt to a student's cognitive state. If EEG signals indicate a student is losing focus or feeling overwhelmed, the learning material could adjust. Maybe it offers a break or presents information in a different way. This neuroadaptive technology could make learning more efficient and engaging, tailoring the educational experience to the individual brain. It's like having a tutor who can read your mind in a helpful way, helping us understand how we learn best. There's also potential in creative fields and skill enhancement. Musicians or athletes could use neurofeedback guided by AI to optimize their performance. The Pandora's box of mind reading, ethical red flags. Now we must turn to the other side of this cosmic coin. The ethical considerations are profound and, frankly, a bit scary. If AI can read thoughts, what happens to mental privacy? Our thoughts have always been our most private sanctuary, the one place where we are truly free. If this technology becomes widespread, could that sanctuary be invaded? Imagine employers wanting to scan employees' brains for productivity, or governments using it for surveillance or interrogation. The potential for misuse is enormous. The concept of cognitive liberty becomes crucial, the right to control your own thoughts and consciousness. Who owns your brain data? You? The company that made the scanner? The AI developer? What if this data is hacked or sold? Could it be used to discriminate against people? These are not just abstract worries, they are real possibilities we need to address. Navigating the future, thought technology, promise and peril. So here we are, at the edge of a new frontier in understanding ourselves. AI-powered thought reading technology holds immense promise. It offers hope for communication, healing and expanding human capabilities. The ability to give voice to the voiceless is a profound gift. The potential to better understand and treat neurological and mental health conditions is transformative. These are noble goals, driven by scientific curiosity and compassion. The universe of the mind is vast, and AI is our new telescope, allowing us to see an inner cosmos we've only dreamed of exploring. But this journey into the mind is not without its dangers. The ethical perils are significant, like navigating an asteroid field. Privacy, cognitive liberty, misuse, misinterpretation, manipulation. These are not small hurdles, they are fundamental challenges. We must proceed with caution, with wisdom, and with a strong ethical compass. The development of this technology cannot happen in a vacuum. It requires open discussion involving scientists, ethicists, policymakers, and the public. We need to build guardrails to ensure it serves humanity, not the other way around. The future is not predetermined, it's what we choose to make it. We can choose to develop this technology responsibly. Found this helpful? Give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you never miss out on future updates.